In this text ring jewelry CAD tutorial mini series number 4, I'm going to show you two things. Number 1, discuss the limitation on the text thickness, width, and the height for 3D printing. Second, I'm going to talk about the text layout and how to flow it back to the ring band. Let's get started. Alright, our last one for the text ring tutorial mini series, we would like to talk about this ring band has a lot of text on it. And a lot of time this is not too difficult at all on the model, and which I also use a lot of this command in the past. But what is interesting and you need to take in precaution is when you wanted to print this. So let's dissect this a little bit. If we take a look on the profile, you're going to see there's a lot of gap in between. And with those gap, sometimes the gap is too small, something like this, that might cause the problem. But since this is tapered out a little bit, as you can see, if we kind of moving in a little bit, it tapered out a little bit. What's gonna cause the problem is the gap is too small and the text itself is too tall, then you might run into the problem. So I would like to give you some numbers here to help you on your model. So let's talk about the first things we need to be cautioned here. Number one, the text distance in between each other, that you may want to keep it at least 0.4 millimeter, which means the distance between those two spots right here, in between the text here, it should be 0.4 millimeter to be safe. With the same number that go into number two is the text itself. The width is minimum 0.4 millimeter as well for have the better printing quality, which is over there. It should be 0.4 millimeter. Number three, the height of the text. You don't want to get it more than 0.6 millimeter if you have something is already really minimum, and you don't want it to be really uncomfortable when you wear this text ring. Number four, we wanted to have the radius all over around the edges, which is going to be easier for our casting. To build this model from scratch, we want to starting from the ring shank for radius 8 or diameter for 16. And then we want to go to the right view and build a profile. I intended to have two rolls of the text, and each of the text is about 4 millimeter. So I will need to have at least 10 millimeter width on the surface that I'm going to build. So let me snapping into the quadrant over there on the top. And then I want to 5 millimeter on each side, so I'm typing 5 here. So that is a interior area for me. And then I'm going to open my grip snap, and I'm going to snapping into the grip roughly about something like this. Depends on how tall, how thick that you want it to have your piece. Now I have this, all I need to do is move it back to the quadrant from the midpoint, from the bottom to there. All right, so let's take a look on the perspective view. This is my perspective view. Before I'm making this ring, I would like to give in the radius ahead of the time. So what we can do is I want to give a big radius right there, roughly about 1. Then you will see this is nice comfort fit ring shank on the inside of the ring shank. And then I want to give a little bit small radius, maybe 0.3 here. So we want to do something like this. And again right here, and the same things on the other side as well. Let's go to surface sweep 1 and rail cross section, and we will get this ring here. Now with this ring, we notice that the here is the line to be a little bit darker. That's where the seam is, which is good on the top, so easier for us to manipulate it. Now what we wanted to do is we need to create a UV curve. So let's go to the curve from the objects, and then you have a create UV curve. Now we want to pick up this surface not this one, this one right there. All right, so this is the surface that we are going to edit. Now you can put in any text right here, you just kind of need to work on the length of it. So I'm going to use the text, with the text box that you have here, I want it to be 5 millimeter tall and I want it to be solid. The thickness, since we don't want to have a wall more than 0.6 millimeter, but we do want it able to intersect. So I want to set it up at 1 millimeter. And I'm going to use the font, Arial Round, and try to make it bold, and let's type it. And then once we type the text, then we want to click OK, and we want to put it right there. We kind of need to move in a little bit there. Now, if the distance in between is kind of too big for you, you might want to go back one step, and when you try to use this, you can actually add the spacing. If the spacing it was too big, and then you want to decrease the space, let's use a negative 0.2. And you can see that they are getting a little bit closer. Now you can have the style, which is having the text is actually stick together or something like this. And that may become quite interesting on the aesthetic. So you can kind of play with something like this. That will work as well. All right, I will leave the eye like this since it's there's a metal behind it, so you don't have to worry about a little text is coming out like that. So I kind of going to fast forward and quickly edit this part so you won't feel too bored. Before you do anything further, make sure the things we will discuss earlier about the distance between the text and also the height of the text and the thickness of the text. Apply those strategy into it will ensure you have a better 3D printing process. But this is a demonstration I'm just gonna use like this to show you what's the next step. We are going to cap this so it will be a surface right there. And then let's take a look on the perspective. So make sure that my text is sitting on exactly on the surface, so make sure they are, look at the front view, they are not, right? So I'm going to pick up all my text and also the surface that I have, and I'm going to use the align tool, align to the bottom, type in 0 so it will snapping into the Z construction. So that way they are 100% touch there. Now we need to do is to flow it back to the ring. So let's take a look on this. My line is intentionally look darker because I adjusted, so it's easier for you to see on the video. Your may not be so dark like this. Okay, so let's go into the transform, and you have flow along the surface, and I'm going to pick up all my text right there, but not my curve and my surface. And then once you're done, you hit enter, then you pick up one of the corner, and then you pick up the target corner. So one is the flow, you can see it is exactly the distance that we have from L to the edge, and then you have something like this. Alright, so if this is what you wanted to do, and this is what you like, you can go ahead and bowling it, and you should be done with this ring. On top of what I offer now in my channel, I would like to expand my channel content to all 3D model printing subjects. I'm curious about what you like to know the most. For example, you can ask me how to be a freelance jewelry designer, the advice for the Rhino beginner, should I buy Rhino Gold or Metric Gold? Can Rhino do an organic shape? Should I go to the college for jewelry design, etc. The more detail on the questions, the more accurate feedback I can give back. Please leave your question in the comments below. Let me know what you'd like to know about Rhino or the related subjects. I will collect all the information and may be able to do additional videos to answer all your curiosity. Thank you, and see you next Monday.